be yourself. If anyone has a problem with who you are, they need to look themselves in the mirror. To see where the true problem lies. Everyone, it's Ephemeral Rift, and I hope you're doing well. This particular topic was suggested by a viewer in the comments under one of my previous vlogs. And I think it's a good topic worth discussing because being yourself, it's not just about being able to be who you are around people, but it can also relate to being truthful, being who you are towards others, and not being fake, phony, a fraud, and putting up a front. So there's going to kind of ramble a little bit on this topic while I eat some, I'll eat my little lunch here, although by the time you're watching this, it's probably no longer lunchtime. First, I'd like to ask you, do you feel that you can be yourself all the time? Or do you feel there are certain people, whether it's friends, social circle, co-workers, family members, that you feel that you can't be yourself around? And what I mentioned at the beginning of the video was a little thing that I was kind of thinking about to kind of encapsulate, I guess you could say, the thought around what it means to be yourself. You know, sometimes we don't feel that we can be ourselves because others are very judgmental, cruel, you know, name-calling, making fun of us, things like that, or making fun of others. And the people that do that, think about it, there's nothing wrong with you at all. None of us are perfect. Everyone has flaws. I have mine. Even the people that try to point out your flaws or our flaws or make fun of us or what have you. And the reason they do that is because they are projecting their own insecurities onto you. The shadow. And I'm not sure if any of you are familiar with Carl Jung, last name spelled J-U-N-G. Now, I'm no expert on the subject. I believe I was introduced to Carl Jung through the works of Tool, the band Tool. They talk about shadow. I think it was 46 and 2, the song, stepping through my shadow, shedding skin and all that. And Carl Jung says, or thought, wrote about, and I want to read more about him. I want to purchase one of his books. There's actually a whole mindset. I think it's Jungian philosophy. He says the shadow is our subconscious, the things that we don't think about consciously. So, for instance, if I was to call someone, if I was to, you know, whether it's, say I was to pick on someone, well, I'm actually projecting something about myself onto the other person. There's something about that person it's almost like I'm mirroring my flaws or what I feel about myself, my insecurities, onto that person. You know, if I'm uncomfortable around someone, why am I uncomfortable around them? Why do I feel the need to bully? If I, for instance, like take bullying, aside from bullies being bullied themselves, why do people feel a need to pick on those who are weak? Because there's something inside of them, in their subconscious, in their shadow, making them do that. I don't want to get into too much because it's something I need to read about, so I don't want to talk like I'm an expert on it. Let's just take a basic experience that I have running this channel and some of the videos that I make. I've been called a freak, weird, all this stuff throughout the course of my channel. You know, throughout the course of my life. And I've done that myself. I'm not going to sit here like I'm on a high horse and act like I've been this perfect saint all my life. No, I've said and done things and picked on people when I was younger and immature for my own insecure reasons. Now, I was bullied too, but that's no excuse. And I wasn't a bully myself. But you know, if I was to say you're weird, man, you know, and the whole thing, what is it? That's I'm projecting myself. You know, there's something about this individual or this group of people that I don't understand. I feel subconsciously that, or consciously that, it's a threat. Let's open up the windows a little bit. And so it's bringing out the people and you. And we bring out things in other people's subconscious that they haven't yet faced. That's really what's happening when we feel that we can't be ourselves around certain people, because there's certain people that make us feel that way. And I know this is one part of the topic about being yourself. Like I said, I want to talk about being true. An honest person and not putting up being fake or a fraud. But you know, when people lash out, you know, it's not you. There's something within them that you're bringing out, that you are making them face. I don't want to say a weakness, but you're making them bring to the surface something that they haven't yet been able to face within themselves. That's pretty much what it is. I mean, that's my take. my whole take on the shadow thing at a high level. I like to look at things from a big picture point of view, to see the forest for the trees, so to speak. So that's why, you know, that just kind of explains why people may make us feel, or make you feel, that you can't be yourself. But there's nothing wrong with you. You know, be yourself always. And if you have friends that make you feel ashamed of yourself, or that you can't be yourself with, then you should reconsider. I would suggest reconsidering why you're friends with them in the first place. A friend, and I don't want to get too much into this topic, friends should accept you for your good times, and not just be a fair weather friend. Accept you for the good times, accept you for the bad times, when you go through, you know, when you're having a hard time and you need their support. The same goes for you too. I mean, it's a give and take. It shouldn't always just be take, and it shouldn't always just be give. You know, we all need support, and we all should offer support as friends. It's a two-way street. But they should also be accepting of who you are. You know, we all have flaws. We have good points, and we have bad points about ourselves. There's no such thing as weird. What's weird is not being accepting of people's uniqueness, and that's weird. What's weird is being ignorant. That's weird. Being shallow. Being a fraud. Putting up a front. Not being genuine. That's what's really weird. What's normal is being yourself. But there's so many people out there, there's so many of you, and with so many different mindsets and philosophies and faiths and combinations of that, with musical tastes and musical interests, and I mean, there's so many hobbies and interests out there, and the things that we like, and our abilities. You know, that's so. If you ever have a problem with people, you know, if there's one thing that I would like to inspire from being here, from existing, aside from helping people to relax and things like that, is for people to be themselves and not think what anyone else has to say or think. And like I said, if anyone has a problem with you, with who you are, they actually have a problem with themselves. That's what it is. So you should, as people, we need to be more accepting and understanding and tolerant of each other. No one should ever feel ashamed of who they are. When it comes to being yourself, it doesn't mean to be a jerk or either. Be yourself, but don't be yourself to the point where, well, you should always be yourself. But I mean, what I mean is to where you're overbearing, or where you're, well, like I said, being a jerk, you know? Like, take, for instance, myself, right? I do a lot of, you know, I like to be silly and goofy and sarcastic, you know, and unconventional. you know, at home with people, but there's a limit. You know, I won't constantly just try to crack jokes all the time or be sarcastic all the time. There's a limit, you know, and you don't come off as being a jerk, you know, where you're, you know, you are, if you like, you are who you are, but you're not constantly just being overbearing on others, if you know what I mean. It's everything in moderation. People should accept you for who you are. If you like, let's say you love to talk about music. Well, people should be accepting of you talking about music, but you shouldn't always just dominate a conversation about music. It's like I said, it's moderation, it's give and take. You should be accepting of each other, but you shouldn't dominate others. It's pretty much, you know, with who you are. You should just be yourself. That's it. That kind of makes sense, if you know what I'm trying to say there. And when it comes to being yourself, I find, personally, that I love to see people being themselves. For instance, whether they're, you know, you just, you know, there's, you'll see them maybe creating something unique, saying something that you're like, wow, you know, speaking their mind. And people who are fearless, that when people are themselves, that's, it takes, you know, in this world, because this world is not as accepting and tolerant as it should be as a species. It takes some bravery. It does take a little bit amount of fearlessness to be oneself, to put up with criticism and to put up with name calling, because unfortunately that's the world we live in, the world we live in. And when I see someone speak out, not just for the sake of speaking out, or being, you know, or being offensive just for the sake of being offensive. But when I see someone who's not afraid to be who they are, they get my respect. And I love to see that. It's like, you know, when I see someone being honest and not putting up a fake, not being fake, not being a fraud, not being phony, you know, those people get my respect too. It's been challenging being myself. I'm not sure if any of you feel the same way. I've had a hard time with friends. I never really knew why. Even sometimes family members may not have understood me. I like to go over the top. You know, like I said, you know, I have a video where I wrote fuck on my forehead. That was over the top, but that was kind of to convey a message. that whole video was, actually. If you're curious, it's the Get to Know Me. Just look up Get to Know Me Ephemeral Rift, I guess, and you'll see the video I'm talking about. I was trying to make some points in there, too, but if I wanted to, I could be offensive for the sake of being offensive. But I like to put meaning in into things. I love comedians like Bill Hicks, George Carlin, Lewis Black, Doug Stanhope. You know, some people may find them offensive, but they're not. They make intelligent points, and they use what people think is strong language. And I hate this whole thing. This is another topic I'm going to talk about one day. This whole thing about strong language and bad language, you know, cursing and swear words. They're just words. I'm not talking about the abusive words when it comes to sexuality, sexual preference, or race. But, you know, they're just being themselves. And I love that. I'm not saying you have to be offensive to be yourself, but, you know, there is a point, and I know some people who are constantly swearing, and it gets a little too much. You know, everything in moderation. But, you know, I love when people are themselves, and if there's one thing, like I said, I hate to repeat myself, there's one thing I can inspire people with just by being here and existing on YouTube or whatever, it's to just send the message of be yourself. That's what I've been doing on this channel. I'll take criticism when it's said in a polite and respectful manner. And I do listen to the viewers, and I'll try to, you know, do some videos for them and the tingles, the triggers that they like and things like that. But for the most part, you know, I run this channel and I do things not to say my way, but I'm just being myself, and I go from day to day with whatever I might idea I have, always trying to think about the viewers and things like that. But I'm just being myself. This is as real as I can get with you. You know? And it's important that if you feel that you can't be yourself, that you address that. If there's certain friends or family members who don't understand you or have a hard time understanding what hobbies or interests, talk. Communicate. That's what we need to do in this life. Communication is key. I mean, we are more accepting and tolerant, you know, overall than back in the 50s and 60s, but there are still pockets of people that, you know, are still, I should say, are ignorant or refuse to be open-minded. But if your parents don't understand you, or the hobbies you're into, you know, if you smoke, if you draw provocative, you know, art or anything like that, I mean, if you're not into anything that's sick and twisted, then there's no reason for anyone to not understand and be accepting and tolerant of who you are, especially your parents. You know, just say, hey, Mom, Dad, listen, you know, you make me feel that I can't be myself. You make me feel ashamed sometimes because of this hobby or this interest or what I do, you know. And I wanna discuss that with you. It's important. It's part of who I am, and this is what I like. And you know, that's the conversation, a nice calm, non-confrontational conversation. And you know, you might not only get them to understand and accept you for who you are. Not that they don't, your parents don't, or your friends, or whoever it might be. But you might actually help them open up their eyes and their mind to what you do. You know, show them what you do. Explain to them what it is. You know, it's some people just don't understand. And, you know, Sometimes you can get through to people. Sometimes even with that conversation, you won't. But I think you owe it to yourself to at least try. Because then you get it out and you've done it. And if they're still unaccepting, and it's on them. Like I said, it goes back to their shadow. It goes back to them not, for whatever reason, them having some kind of insecurity about themselves. And that's why they're not accepting or tolerant of you, because there's a part of them that they're not accepting or tolerant of in the first place. That's what it really is. You know, if I call, like I said, I had to repeat myself, but when I say, you know, oh, you play video games, you're one of those gamer nerds or whatever. Well, no, you're not. It's that I have an issue with myself, and I am closed-minded or whatever it is. There's something within me, in my subconscious, that's coming out to the surface and makes me feel the need, makes people feel the need to call one another names or not be understanding of each other. And that's, like I said, I have to kind of agree with that whole Jungian philosophy, or however you might say it, the shadow. You know, everybody has a shadow. So, that's really the main thing I wanted to talk about when it comes to being yourself, is the common discussion that most people have about not feeling comfortable and how to deal with being themselves around people who are judgmental or ignorant or don't want to be understanding. But it also encompasses being an honest person and not putting up a front towards others, not being a fraud or a fake or a phony, because no one appreciates that, no one respects that. I know I don't. And people know when others are in it for the money, for the fame, friends for the wrong reasons, things like that. Now, honesty and sincerity are really valued. A lot of people really value those. I know I do, and I look for that in others as well when it comes to friendships or the people that I trust. So being yourself, always. And if you lose friends, it's their loss. It's their loss. There's nothing wrong with you. They're flawed too. We're all flawed. There is no such thing as perfection. There's not. So, thanks to the viewer that suggested that. Thanks to all of you, as always, for watching, for your support. I hope you enjoy this vlog. Love to hear what you think about this topic. Do you feel that you can be yourself? You know, what are some of the challenges? You know, is there something I missed that maybe I could have talked about more? Maybe I can do that another time in a future vlog. But always be yourself. And don't be ashamed of who you are. Never. Not with me, at least. So stay tuned for the next vlog. It's going to talk about the ego. That should be quite an interesting topic to discuss. Also, another recommendation from another viewer. Alright, everyone. Hope you're doing well. I'm doing quite alright. Thanks for asking. For those of you that sometimes like to know, you know, I have no complaints compared to those who are, you know, much worse off than I. So, take care of yourself, and until next time, be yourself and tingle on. Bye-bye.